for you. But let's take a look at some other issues that we're talking about here. We'll get to the markets in just a bit. But one particular issue that came up starting on Tuesday was the fact that Nigeria's acting president, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, approved a 60-day national action plan aimed at the ease of doing business in the country, targeting some low-hanging fruits, if you like, for quick wins. Now, the approval was given at the sixth meeting of the Presidential Enabling Business Environment Council in Abuja, the nation's federal capital territory. Well, according to Professor Osinbajo, the 60-day action plan is targeted at three broad areas. One, the entry and exit of goods. Two, entry and exit of persons into Nigeria. And three, the general government transparency and efficiency in agencies as well as parastatals. Well, Joe Femi Dagunru, an economic policy analyst and chief strategist at Westphalia Resources, joins me now to talk about this. A good morning to you. Thank you so much for coming on the program.
Good morning.
So it's quite a packed program, as you would have seen, and getting that curtain raiser now from Bosin, still taking a look at the environment. This presidential, this approval, the 60-day approval now that has come from the federal government, what do you make of it?
Well, that's a good idea. It's a laudable idea if we can achieve that. You will realize that having ideas and having policies have never been our problem in this country, but the execution and the monitoring of those policies and those programs, if you are looking at this, this is what is expected of us. And if Nigeria has to go this way, it will excite a lot of people. I mean, investors looking at the transparency we talk about, looking at the registration of companies. I mean, talking about the Corporate Affairs Commission being, you know, revived. I mean, kind of to be able to perform. And it's a good thing, but how good it will be, it is the execution that will determine that. Yeah. So now, this is not a project that should be considered with, what's it called now, quota system. Competent people have to be placed in place to make this work. It is not about whether you are from south, south, southwest, or southeast. Competent people, experts to make this thing work. It has been working elsewhere, and it should be able to work in Nigeria. If you say, look, you want to register a company within 24 hours, yes, it's possible. But look, if the website is well done, I mean, but now, you know, just for the purpose of coming to this meeting, I clicked on that thing, and I discovered that the search engine is not working. So you cannot just search. Before we say these things, as good, as laudable as they can be, let's be sure that we put all those things in place, in good functioning order. So now, if you go there and say you are searching a name, a business name, and the thing says, okay, no, this thing is not working, then it seems as if nothing has been done, that it's not been properly coordinated. So right from that point, we have to make sure that things, this the technology has to make sure that it works well for us. And looking at it, this is not the first time people will say that, listen, you can clear your goods within 30 days. It's possible, but who are the people to monitor this? When you get the manifest, before the thing comes into this country, you already had the manifest, you know what is coming in, you know how it's going to take, you know the clearing agents and all that. Before it comes in, everything should be put in place so that when it comes in, you don't need to delay this, you know, these goods or the containers or whatever, and make sure that, I mean, there was a time we were talking about scanning all these things. When they come in, are we really having the scanning machine? Have we trained them to scan properly? So these are laudable projects. These are things that can work. It has been working elsewhere. If you go to Rwanda, I said that some time ago, within some few hours, you register your company. So it can work here as well. So it's just how to put it in order, how to monitor it, how to make sure that people work on it. And when you're looking at this, if you want to set up these media parks or business parks, or technology park, you don't need to start building new offices again. Look at the federal secretariat in Lagos wasting away there. You can simply start using what we have right now to begin to achieve those goals, and then you will save money, save time, and at the end of the day, put the right folks there.
But then in terms of talking about registration now, it's supposed to be very easy for you to go to the CAC website and be able to find out if you have, if you can get your business registered,
right.
Find out if the business name has already been taken up and the rest of it. And you already talked about the fact that it was difficult for you to even, you know, browse. So low internet penetration is still a very strong issue that needs to be tackled, and that comes to the table of the Ministry of Information and Technology.
Yes, unfortunately, that has to be addressed separately. But this, in making sure that you want to make this project, I call it project now, to work. First of all, it's like a search engine. You know, you don't need to pay anything. Just go in there and put your name, Harriet, LTD, and it's supposed to come out and tell you that this is them, but it's not working right
now. It will only be possible if you have good internet.
Okay, not only that. Apart from that, we have to decentralize this commission. decentralize it. You don't need to get to Abuja. You can have it done at Koshofe local government or Shomolu local government. Things are being done in local government. Business names are supposed not to be something you have to take to Abuja, for goodness sake. Decentralize this thing and register it in your next local government. And not only that, even if you have access to the internet, some people will not go with that. How to upload, how to download, how to print. So that means you need a business center, and you still have to take the services of maybe commercial lawyers or secretaries who will do that. Mm. And it's not something you just feel online. And these are the things we have to look into. Find idea. But I want to believe that somebody must have a good thought of this and say, look, how do we do this within 60 days? You have seen there's a guideline, timeline on the website that says, okay, within 3 days, within 2 days. It can be possible, you know, because if I go there this morning and I said I want to search my name and I couldn't get it, how do I upload? How do I download? And, you know, you have to think about the problem of electricity as well. You want to do it, there's no electricity. So there are a lot of things, but it's a good step in the right direction. So how do we execute it?
But in executing it now, the directive has given that the number of agencies handling, you know, entry and exit of goods has to be reduced to just six. Past administrations have actually given similar instructions to make these numbers a little more compact and reduce the hassles of having to go around all of those multiple agencies. Do you think this time it will make a difference?
Well, it depends on who is behind the scene, who is driving.
You have the Minister of you have the Ministries of Trade, Investment, you have the Ministries of Finance, you have the Ministries of the key ministries.
Well, this should not be all a ministry thing. If we leave it to the ministry kind of thing and all, that would be prostrated, that would be bureaucracy as well. And we have to cut down this bureaucracy. Go to the international airport. You see how many agencies, I mean, trying to stop you, check you, and all that. So the same thing I want to believe at the ports. So now what we have to do, it is not just about the ministries and ministry. Key competent people who will be reporting to a particular, you know, a coordinator of this program. If you have to say, look, ministries have to be there again, then you have about six ministries, and six ministries will bring their own directors, and directors will have to wait again for Abuja. It will become bureaucratic and it will not work. Then what we are saying is, let it work, let it be competent people, and cut this bureaucracy.
And if it has to be competent, of course you need to get the buy-in of the National Assembly.
Right. You see, I think the National Assembly folks there, they should work for us, not against us. This is something, it is not just to say to investors and say, listen, we have 170 million people come to Nigeria. That is an old stuff. Nobody wants to listen to that again. You want to see that. I want to see that in Germany or somewhere in UK and say, okay, look, let me check this name. You want to register a name? In some countries like the UK, for instance, people even register, you can sell even immediately, because these things have been done. So, and it doesn't cost you so much, but now we are seeing it that it can be done. But we have been proposing this for a long time. I wonder why some of these things are not working right now. I expect that the CAC website, you have about three alternative websites, CACNigeria.com, CACNigeria.net, good idea, but it must be functional. And the functionality begins with the search of names. And like I said, these authorities, they have the right to all be there. You have this committee with all these people that are there, ministers. But then, I'm saying it, it's not about the ministers who are six or five sitting down. It's about the competency of the people. So now, if it can't work, then it's about the people. And the people at the National Assembly, they have to get people to advise them accordingly. I think one of the reasons is this. We have people who do not know much about certain things, but they believe that they know. And rather than calling people who understand this, how it works, to advise them, they want to do it alone. And then when it runs to that block, and we say, look, we can't go any further, then we start blaming, oh, it's the vice president, it's this and that.
But 60 days is enough for at least the council to know what the teething problems will be and how best it will be to address those teething problems.
I tell you what, I don't know why the idea about the 60 days. Before you announce 60 days, you must have seen that things have been put in place.
Well, the 60 days is supposed to be like a test run to see if you can achieve all of this within 60 days or less.
Yes, it's possible. Like I said, people have to make it work. Whoever that is behind the scene that says, okay, listen, we want it for 60 days to test run it, you must have put all those things in place to make it work for 60 days. But whoever that is listening or watching us right now, I'm telling you that now go there, you see that the search engine is not functioning. And then if it doesn't function, then that is minus from these 60 days. You can put right. And then it is not enough to say, look, my browser is working, your Cloudflare is working, but between the Cloudflare and the website, the server is not connecting. It's a simple thing. That means somebody has to be checking this around the clock 24/7. It's not something you just do once and leave it and say it's working and we have this kind of embarrassment. This is an embarrassment.
Okay, so let's leave it at that, and hopefully this conversation will continue after now.
Well, I think it's going to work. Honestly speaking, it's something that should work, and we should make it work. The Assembly guys should make sure that this is an urgent thing to make Nigeria function.
Joe Femi Dagunro, Economic Policy Analyst and Chief Strategist at Westphalia Resources, thank you for your perspectives this morning.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Business Morning continues after now. Stay with us.